I don't know if you guys picked that up, but that was Intel Franklin calling there. You all seem to be watching something. I don't know if it's just there was another giraffe that moved off. They might be watching that. I was just asking Herman if he saw the giraffe with just the white ears showing. Very, very distinctive when they're in the bush. When they're feeding, you can just see the white ears. And that's obviously a visual sign for the other giraffe in the area. And if they're pointing forward, like they're watching something, they're alert to something. I don't think it's something that's going to be causing a problem. You can see her ears also turned towards us. She's listening to us as well. And these are the southern giraffe. There's a huge debate as to whether there's anywhere between one species of giraffe with just different variations in the region, or if there's 13 subspecies of giraffe, the argument being that they can all interbreed, but they're all found in different areas. And the western giraffe is quite endangered. But each one, the pattern is slightly different. Reticulated giraffe, if you have a look at the blocks on this giraffe's neck, they not a very straight lined block, they're sort of a little bit wobbly around the edges, whereas the reticulated are very, very straight, very dark brown, and more of a cream in between. You can see she's starting to chew the cud. I don't know if you could see the movement in the neck there. And now she's just chewing, she's puffing out the cheeks and she's just chewing whatever bolus came up. So whatever they were watching isn't a problem. You can see the zebras. The zebras are just coming to range and they've got their heads down. They're not really too fussed about what's going on. So I think they're more than likely just watching the other giraffe. There's no alarm calls or anything like that from the zebra or the giraffe. It's amazing, giraffes can actually survive on very little water. If they are really pushed, they can survive on about 6 or 7 litres of water a week. If they really have to, if they really are pushed. You know, if you think about, for something like a cow, they would need about 60 litres a day. can also see those very long eyelashes, just silhouetted almost. And again, they share that with other animals like camels. Just helps to keep the dust out their eyes. Obviously other insects and things like that as well. And it's very, very difficult to sneak up on a giraffe. If you're walking through the bush and then you happen to spot a giraffe, most of the time it would have spotted you very, very early on. But they're very, very inquisitive. If they spot you and you see them and you sit down either just behind the bush or just to the side of the bush, quite often they'll actually come over and try to investigate. And I've actually seen them do that to cheetah. There was two cheetah lying down, and there was a whole line of giraffe standing and watching the cheetah, and they're actually almost edging each other on to get closer to have a look. Okay. And welcome on board again, Katie and Natalie. We heard from you yesterday. Apparently you both turned 5 yesterday as well. Gave you a shout out, I believe, yesterday. So it's great to have you back on board with us this afternoon. I think you're enjoying the giraffe as much as we are. I'm just wanting to know, are they horns on top of their head? Well, we call them horns, but they're not like the horns on an antelope or the antlers of a deer. But they're called ossicones. And they are very flat when the baby's first born. So they're actually, the babies are born with them. And when they start to move around and they start to feed, these horns will eventually start to stand up, and then they'll almost be cemented to the head so they stand up straight. And they are actually bone, with skin covering them, with tufts of hair on top of them. And as the youngster grows up, if it's a male, the hair will wear down, because he'll start to fight. When he's about 6 or 7, he'll start to spar or play fight, learn how to fight, and that fur will start to wear off. But with the females, they don't fight, so they don't tend to wear the fur on top of the horns down. But I have seen some bold females, sometimes they'll scratch it on a tree. I think she's still listening to this in the parlour at the back. I think she's still listening to them. You can see her ears are now pointing back. Just keeping a check on what's behind her. The rest of the herd have moved into the bush. And remember, giraffes don't always have to be in a herd. They can be on their own, especially males who move between herds. But it just depends on what they feel like on the day. So if they fancy being on their own, they'll walk away and go on their own. Females, when they give birth, they'll be on their own. I've seen probably about 15 in a herd. That's the most I've ever seen in a herd. What about you, Herman? Have you seen many? No. It tends to be, if you do get a herd, somewhere around 7 or 8, something like that. I say animals definitely have all the time in the world. I remember someone asking about why a hippo just stood on the bank, and I actually saw him do it the other day. He just left the water and just stood on the bank, pretty much like this giraffe's just standing now. As I say, they just have all the time in the world, and there doesn't seem to be any reason for them to do this. It seems to be okay. It's almost like maybe us sitting down on a chair and just resting. But when the giraffe is standing the way this female's standing, this is when they are at rest, the way they hold the head. And if they put the head down, that's when the muscles will actually start to work and contract to pull the head down. And it was actually shown on the Inside Nature's Giants. And they looked inside the giraffe and they actually found that if they did pull the head down, it'd actually spring back to that position. So that was its relaxed position. So no energy is needed for the giraffe to hold its head like that, which is quite incredible. Oh, we'll go and see what the buffalo are doing just around the corner. Maybe you might be able to see the giraffes coming out onto the side of the dam. And if anybody is following us on the map this afternoon, then this is Chelapan. Unfortunately, Chelapan isn't marked on the map. We need to find the junction between dams and the road. It goes from Weaver's Nest Road to Twins Downs Road, and that's where the pan is on the map. And we have the three Duggar boys. Four Duggar boys. And counting. Let's see if we can get a nice view of this male here. Trying to rest in the shade. See if I can actually get up onto the grass there. Finally, looks like they're not being bothered by flies too much today. You see what's moving behind him? There's something just behind the bush. I can't see what it is. Yeah, just above his head. Oh, is it another buffalo? Just moving his head. They say the temperature is very, very hot this afternoon, so that's obviously why the buffalo are looking for some shade. And again, just ruminating while it is hot, and you'll see that a lot more in the summer as well. During the hottest part of the day, a lot of animals will rest, and those that chew the cud will sit in a shady spot if they can and chew the cud, preserve the energy. And I think there's another buffalo behind to the left of this one as well. I think we've got at least six here. And I'm going to see if whoever knows where the term Dugger Boy comes from. Why do we use Dugger Boys for buffalo? See who's the first one to come back to us on that one. I think it's a small group, eh? Now, when it's during the dry season, you will get the males splitting away from the breeding herds, the females, and going off by themselves in a bachelor group. But it does depend on the rains. Some areas where you don't get a very distinct rainy season, then you may get the buffalo males with the females all the time. And you generally get the females with their calves different times or different ages. That you'll get the males escorting the females. And you can get herds a few hundred strong sometimes. Now, if you can imagine, these guys can charge about 57 kilometers an hour. So if you can imagine two males weighing in about 800 kilos, some of the big males maybe even a ton. You can imagine two males charging at each other, maybe from about 30 meters apart. You can imagine the clash between the two. And they are one of Africa's more dangerous animals. They may not look it, but they can be very, very dangerous, especially if you get a lone bull. If they're in a herd, they're a lot more stable. I've walked buffalo herds a couple of times, and if they catch wind of you, they're more likely to move away rather than stand and fight. If you get males by themselves, they're a lot more unstable. They're more likely to challenge you. I wonder if anyone's come through with the answer to my question yet. Why do we call male buffalo Dugger Boys? Awesome, thanks Sharon. Thank you very much Sharon, great to have you on board this afternoon. Saying that Zulu for mud is Dugger. And when the old males get kicked out of the herd by the younger males, they go to where it's muddy areas where it's softer vegetation. Well, thank you very much, Sharon. You're the first off the mark this afternoon. And again, this comes from their teeth becoming worn down as they get older. Same with elephants. And as their teeth wear down, they need to go to where the softer vegetation is, which is next to rivers or water areas. And obviously there's a lot of mud there, and these boys will roll in mud, get themselves caked in mud to help with the flies, to protect them from the sunlight. There you go, you can see the size of this bull. I know he has got a lot of flies with him. I thought he was able to avoid them. Now, if these bulls were to stand right next to Jigger, they would reach over the top of the dashboard, just to try and give you some idea of the size. Oh, here we go, we've got the giraffe and the zebra actually coming down to drink. I'm going to see if I can move around, because it's actually quite awesome to see a giraffe drink. Sorry, boys. Trouble is, I've got to be quite careful, because giraffes are very vulnerable when they're drinking. With the zebra going down to drink, hopefully the giraffe will join them. I wonder if TP from Wild Earth Chat Room is watching. She wanted to know how giraffes drink. Tell me when you can see it nicely. Just here. You get the zebra in as well. So there you go, you can see they splay the legs. And then if it's just a little bit too low down, they may just bend the knees slightly. And the reason why they feel so vulnerable is because those very strong eyes can't see very far when they're right down at the ground. And that's when lions will attack from a bush or something close to the waterhole and grab the giraffe by the neck, and that's when it's going to be the most vulnerable. So they're very, very wary when they come down to a waterhole, and with the, as I say, with the zebra coming down, they can also keep a lookout for any predators, so that's going to make the giraffe more likely to drink. Hi Gary, welcome on board this afternoon. Just wanting to know what the closest relative to the giraffe is. We actually don't have it here, unfortunately. I've only seen it once in my life, and it's an okapi. I think one of its other names is actually a forest giraffe, but it's not really a giraffe. And that lives up in the Congo. And they'll be a little bit smaller than this giraffe you can see feeding on the tree there in front of us. The okapi would probably reach just to the top of its neck. Not the head, just to the where the shoulder is that meets the neck. That's probably where they would stand up to. Okay. Hi, Estonia. Welcome on board again this afternoon. Remember having a question from you yesterday as well. Just wanting to know what the tallest giraffe is in the park. In the park, I'm not too sure. But I know the tallest giraffe on record is about 6 meters, I believe. I think I'm probably better off going this way, actually. But generally, the big males will reach maybe about 5.5. Females about 4.5 meters. But I think the 6 was possibly even a captive bred giraffe. I know the oldest on record was 28 years old. And that was a wild giraffe. But maybe the tallest might have been about 5.8 meters. And obviously the reason why captive animals tends to live longer than wild animals, may even grow larger than wild animals, is because they don't need to worry about where the next meal is going to come from, territorial disputes, anything like that. So they can reach their lifespan and exceed it, or the expected lifespan and exceed it, and as I say, the weights as well. And that's what they actually think, according to the dodo records. Scientists have gone back and had a look at the dodos from Mauritius, and they're always depicted as being very fat, overweight birds. And the scientists have gone back and had a look at the bone structure, and they actually think that it's possibly that they got overfed because they were being utilized for meat. And it could be that the pictures that we see and the records that we have aren't actually the true representation of wild dodos. I don't think our giraffe's going to have any more water, unfortunately. The rest of the herd seem to be moving on. The buffalo are also moving on. So, I think we'll continue on down towards Leadwood and see if we can try and relocate those lions in the area. Though it's always very nice to spend time with giraffes and zebras. Find any tracks left behind to follow for the last 40 minutes of drive or so. Here. Sorry, is that okay there? So with it being so dark, this should be a male, but it's actually a female. She's a very, very dark female, but it just goes to show you can't always go off of one characteristic. Let's go see if we can roll forward a little bit. And if we've got anybody just joining us, my name's Tara. And getting the beautiful shots of the giraffe this afternoon is Herman. Behind the camera there. And the remarkable Mark in final control, forwarding through any questions you might have. And all you need to do is put them in an email, and email them through to finalcontrol@safari.tv. If there's any information that you think people might enjoy hearing, then by all means, got the other giraffe. I think they're going to walk in front of us actually. Maybe join this other female. And in the aptly named Giraffe Dip on Central Road. If you look very carefully, you might actually be able to see tennis ball size movement in the neck as she's chewing the cud. Unfortunately, she's changed her position. My home was showing you quite nicely how thin the legs are, and that just helps with such a high blood pressure. It's almost like a pair of flight stockings, and it just holds all the blood vessels and everything in their leg, and it just wraps it around and just makes sure that there's no blood sort of pooling at the end of the feet and on the legs. So it just keeps it all nice and tight, so that the blood pressure allows the giraffe to get the blood to the head. So obviously it's got about 2 meters to travel up the head against gravity, so it's got to be under a lot of pressure, because otherwise it would just be feeling dizzy all the time. So we're still looking out, with the temperatures getting nice and cool now. Maybe listening out for any of the lions roaring that we were looking for earlier. Any leopards moving around. And obviously with it getting cooler, we may even see some of the nocturnal animals coming out.